The Santa Cruz County Board of Supervisors is getting ready for a big decision tomorrow night. The board is considering a moratorium on new gun shops. The debate comes a month to the day after the tragedy at Sandy Hook Elementary in Newtown, Connecticut. And parents in that community are now making a plea. 20 children and 6 educators were killed at their school. And now the families of the victims are launching what's called the Sandy Hook Promise. They want a national discussion about what led to the tragedy.
I would respectfully request that every parent in this country who hears these words simply pause for a moment and think. Ask yourself, what is it worth doing to keep your children safe?
For now, they are not taking sides in the debate over gun control, violent videos, and the mental health system in this country, but organizers say they do plan to do so in the future. Here on the Central Coast, there is a push to block any new gun stores from opening up in unincorporated Santa Cruz County until some new laws are hammered out. It'll be up for a vote tomorrow at the Board of Supervisors meeting. And as Action News reporter Tom Miller shows us, a lot of people on both sides of the proposed plan are weighing in. Tom's live in our Salinas newsroom with more on what they're saying.
Aaron, what's seen as the problem is that right now there aren't any rules or regulations surrounding gun laws in the county. So when word got out to one supervisor that a new one, a new gun store, wants to move in, he said not so fast.
It was a quick walk down the hall for Supervisor John Leopold when he found out a new gun store wants to open in Live Oak at the El Rancho Shopping Center.
I asked the question to our planning department, what regulations do we have in place to assure safety to the community? And I found that we had none.
He proposed a 45-day moratorium on the opening of any new gun shops.
And the constituents are weighing in. In the last 4 days, the board has received 52 letters in favor of the moratorium to just 11 opposed.
David Foster is among the supporters.
He killed a total of 13 people here in the county.
In 1972, his sister and brother-in-law were murdered in Santa Cruz by serial killer Herbert Mullen. 4 decades later, Foster says easy access to guns is still a problem.
Getting rid of guns isn't going to make people all of a sudden calm and get along with each other, but it's a step in one direction at least.
However, opponents believe more regulations aren't the answer. One email says firearms and ammunition will not be as readily available for law-abiding citizens to protect themselves from those who would do them or someone else harm with a firearm. Another person writes that this means those who get them illegally will be the only ones able to get guns.
The law is clear that we can't take away people's guns. This is not an attempt.
Leopold insists he simply wants some regulations. He suggests a chief law enforcement officer inspect and approve gun store owners annually, that gun store permits aren't transferable, and wants limits on how close the stores can be to schools and playgrounds.
Well, we're trying to come up with reasonable regulations to make sure that the community is safe.
To pass, 4 of the 5 supervisors need to vote in favor of the moratorium on Tuesday. Their decision sure to be controversial regardless of the outcome.
Now, how the supervisors will vote is unclear. Because of the Brown Act, Leopold is only allowed to lobby one other colleague of his, and he'll need 2 out of the other 3 to get on board without any convincing. Aaron.
All right. Thank you, Tom. If passed, the moratorium can be renewed and extended for up to 2 years. If you'd like to go to tomorrow's meeting, it begins at 9:00.